Hello, this is Rob, and I'm going to show you how you can install Windows 10 on an Hyper-V machine. There are basically two ways, the normal way and the quick way. The normal way is the way I prefer because you have more control on what you do, where you install, etc., etc. So let's get started. First of all, you need a Hyper-V. If you still need to install it, there is a different video where I show you how to enable Hyper-V on a Windows machine. But let's get started. So Hyper-V, go over here, new virtual machine. You get this pop-up box. Before you begin, that's a lot of text I don't read. First thing you want to do is give it a name. Windows 10, of course. Oh, Windows 10. Windows 10 test install. Where do I want to locate the virtual machine? Well, I have an SSD drive on G with a folder called Hyper-V. It's still there. That's my 1 terabyte Samsung. So that's where I'm going to place it. You know what? Let's give it its own folder. So now it's going to be stored. The virtual machine is going to be stored in on the G drive, Hyper-V, and the file folder. Okay, next. Because it is Windows 10 on Windows 10, always pick Generation 2. Startup memory. I will assign a gig, but it's dynamic, so it will take more when it needs it. So it's not that important. Configure networking. Default switch. Connect virtual hard drive. Well, that's all okay. Let's give it 60 gigs. I don't have an existing hard drive. No. Well, here's the thing. You need to install Windows 10 from an ISO, which you can download from Microsoft, or you have it on a somewhere. And I need to point where it is. Well, I have one here. I downloaded that yesterday, I think, for my new computer. So it's going to get its information from the windows.iso. So it knows where to find the Windows installation files. And that's it. It's going to create everything. I have to go through the settings first. Yep. That's the most important bit. Okay. Now we are going to start and connect. So now you need to enter all the data like language install. Well, it's pretty self-explanatory. Install now. You can select which one you want to install. Let's say Windows 10 Pro. Here you check your custom install. And it starts copying the files. So I'm going to speed this up for the video, and you can see exactly what happens. So now you select a region where you're at. Let's say, what region would I pick? Well, Netherlands, of course. So here the question, personal use organization. Well, we are going for personal use. Dummy password. You can go for your security questions. This is just a lot of stuff you really don't want. Here you select your monitor size, and I will go full screen. Password. And there it is. So that's basically how you can install Windows 10 on a Hyper-V server or Hyper-V installation. So this Windows 10 is running on Windows 10 to be exact. There is another way you can do this. Not so elegantly shutting it off. Yes, there is another way, and that's a way I don't often use. In fact, I don't use it at all. And that's this way. You can go for a quick create. And then you have some options. You can say same thing basically. You want to have this one. This virtual machine will run Windows 10. Okay. You have some options. Let's say Windows 10 test install 2. Which network switch you want to use. Now it starts creating the new virtual machine. And now the virtual machine is created. You can see it here. And you can do two things. Connect, it starts and gives you a hassle. Sometimes it works. Or you can go through the settings. And I would suggest you go through the settings first. Important, always start from the Windows DVD, or it won't start. Enable secure boot because you're running Windows. It already assigned 2 gigs dynamic memory, that's important. It already signed 4 virtual processors, that is a bit much, but okay. Yeah, for the rest it's all pretty well here. It did what it did. I would pick a subfolder, location where it gets its stuff from, and a lot of switches. Let's pick the default. So that's basically what it has set up. All a bit default. And now you can start it and it just starts. So that's the other way of quick creating. Let's see what it does. Yeah, now it goes through the same process of installing Windows 10, but I'm going to skip this because we already went through it. So that's installing Windows 10 latest version as of May 2021. So that's it for me. Thank you. Bye bye.